this workshop. I was participating last year, I think, but I was online, so I couldn't get to you so well. So this year, we decided, me and my colleague, I work in two places, actually. I'm a PhD student at Bulgarian Institute of Astronomy, and on the other hand, I'm a teacher in observatory, which name is Nicolaus Copernicus, at Varna, which is a city in Bulgaria too. So this poster is about our work as a teachers, me and my colleague Eva Buzurova. We have a lot of things that we are doing during the school year. Our students are from, let's say, 13 years old to 18 years old, and they're doing a lot of experiments, not only on astronomy and physics too. For example, one of our experiments is related with Herschel experiment for infrared wavelengths. So we just do it, all the experiments, and from the ancient people from Greek in our courses, but we also do a lot of observations. We had two observatories. One is in Varna, where is the observatory, but the other, but the other is about 30 kilometers from Varna, where we can do very, very nice observations. And here is our observation of Galileo moons. So this project or observation was made by students which were 14 years old. So they observed photographically the Galileo moons, and by using the Kepler third wall, because they know Kepler walls, they can first of all obtain the period of each of the moons, Galileo moons, and then they can calculate the mass of Jupiter, which is a very nice example how you can inspire the school students with this kind of observation, and then mixing the observation with theory, how it's working. Then there was we are doing observation and measuring of, for example, we have a telescope with which we can take picture of sun and the sunspots. And for our little students, we manage them to measure how big is one spot or the group of the spots, and so much stuff like this. So we have made in our tool to measure the altitude of the sun during the day, how it's changing. But our main goal for participating here is to know each other with other colleagues from other planetariums or institutions that are interested in teaching students in school, because in our country, unfortunately, we have a couple of planetariums, but we want to share our experience and to get new ideas what we can do. So if you are interested, just contact me, and I'm here.
Okay, thanks, Antoaneta.
Thank you.
Any comments or questions? Karma?
You can have the stars located. You can just put the stars from the floor at different drawing the constellation. But then, if you take into account the 3D dimension of the parallax distances, then you can show the constellation as it is from your perspective. But then you can change your perspective, and this allows you to visualize the parallax that you were asking before.
Mm-hmm.
And also, yeah, I've done that with people and very young children, and it is like it's a way also to link with Gaia, because the parallax is the distance.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
So, yeah.
Okay, so I will ask you later.
Yeah, congratulations for the work that you do, because I think it's very important.
By the way, we are
the
only
young people.
We are only 3 teachers at our observatory.
Okay.
So, and in the town, around the town, we are only 3 teachers teaching astronomy. In the school, there's basically no astronomy.
Okay.
Or it's just for the planet. So thank you very much.
Wait. In Mexico, we have also some science exhibitions, and something has been very successful along the lines that they were talking about. You use a box for shoes, and then you put a little balls with the strings, and then you put them in a 3-dimensional pattern, and then you draw 2 little holes on one side of the box, and then the student can look at it from one side and then from
the other,
and you illustrate the concept of the parallax. The other thing you can do is that you can arrange it in such a way that when you see it from one side, you see a familiar pattern like the Big Dipper or Orion or whatever, but then you look it from the side and then you realize that they are not together. They are at many different distances.
Oh, we had a lesson about this. I did something like we took one constellation and we see the distance from Earth to the star, whatever it is, the star, and then they had to reconstruct the constellations by using sticks, but the sticks, the height of the sticks must be scaled.
Okay.
So they can see that the stars are not in one plane, they are different.
No, I think this is very important, because most of the people think that the sky is flat, it's a celestial sphere. So to bring to them the depth is very important.
Also
comment from the online participant? No? Okay, well, thanks.
Thank you.